strength of the asset. Now, when we talk about the strength of the asset, and on the basis of strength, assets are of two types. Either it can be a strong asset or it can be a weak asset. This same categorization is also found in the basis. Bases are also strong bases as well as weak bases, depending upon the strength of that base. But now we will discuss only about the assets in this video. So now when we talk about the strong assets, so all those assets which completely dissociate to form hydrogen ion is known as a strong asset. So for example, if I have HCl, now when this HCl will dissociate, it will form H positive and Cl negative. So we will have hydrogen as a positive ion and fluorine as a negative ion. Now when such a reaction is being going on and there is complete dissociation of the hydrogen ion, that means this acid is a strong acid. However, if there is partial or incomplete dissociation of the hydrogen ion, that is referred to as a weak acid. Like all organic acids, as I have discussed in the earlier videos on the organic and mineral acids, so all organic acids are weak acids. Like we have acetic acid. So the chemical formula of acetic acid is CH3COOH. This is the chemical formula of acetic acid, which contains carbon, hydrogen and oxygen as the elements. Now when dissociation of acetic acid is being going on, it results into H positive ion and we have acetate ion. The chemical formula of acetate ion is that CH3COO with a negative sign. Now in such type of reaction, there is partial dissociation of the hydrogen ion. That means acetic acid is a weak acid. Other examples may include tartaric acid, even carbonic acid are all examples of weak acids. However, sulfuric acid, nitric acid are examples of the strong acids. This was the classification of acids based upon the strength. In my previous video, I have discussed the classifications of acids based upon their composition. You must refer to that video also offered by Abhyas Online.